Hi, I'm Avi, a real estate agent in Brookline. In the hottest part of the market here, we're seeing buyers increasingly waive their mortgage contingency as a way to stand out from other buyers. When the buyer waives the financing contingency and they need financing, they inevitably are accepting some risk of losing that deposit, but there are ways to limit it. And if something does happen, sometimes you can work with the seller. But there's no way around the fact that there are risks when waiving the financing contingency. The buyer will make the offer. When it gets accepted, the buyer makes a $1,000 deposit. By the time you get to the purchase and sale, usually about 2 weeks later, the deposit gets increased to usually about 5% of the purchase price. So on a $1 million purchase, that's $50,000. That's a lot of money. So why are buyers doing this? It's a way to compete against other buyers and make one offer look better than another. I'd estimate that about a quarter to a third of the bids on a really hot property will have the mortgage contingency waived. Let's talk a bit about what the financing contingency is and some of the risks that are involved in waiving it, and then some ways to mitigate some of those risks. Then you can discuss with your agent if it makes sense for you and your strategy. So the financing contingency is something that the buyer includes in their offer, and it's usually something along the lines of if the buyer doesn't get a mortgage for some amount or some percent of the purchase price by a certain date, then they're allowed to back out of the deal and get their deposits back. Now, this gives some protection to the buyer for things that are often out of their control. Imagine, for example, a scenario where the appraisal comes in low. This is not something that the buyer can control. Imagine that the buyer and seller had agreed on a purchase price of $1 million. The buyer was planning to get 80% financing or a mortgage for $800,000 and was going to pay $200,000 cash for the down payment. The appraisal comes in and says, it's not worth $1 million, it's worth $900,000. We'll still lend you 80%, but only 80% of the 900,000. So now the buyer has a loan for 720, but they only have the 200,000 in cash. So they have to come up with the other $80,000. With the financing contingency, the buyer can choose to proceed and come up with the difference, or to back out and get their deposit back. If the buyer doesn't have that financing contingency, then if they can't come up with the extra $80,000 to plug that hole, then they'd have to lose their deposit and back out of the deal unless the seller is willing to lower the price. There's other risks other than just the appraisal coming in low. The bank could reject an entire condominium project and say, we're not willing to lend on that condo association. Or the bank could say on this particular borrower, we know we pre-approved you for up to $1 million purchase, but on evaluating your documents further, we no longer feel we can lend you that amount. We're only going to lend you a lesser amount. So that's what the financing contingency is for, to protect the buyer from these scenarios that are outside of their control. There's ways to waive the financing contingency and limit some of that risk. For example, the buyer could waive the mortgage contingency, but insert an appraisal contingency. So this is a smaller contingency than for all the other reasons. Another thing that buyers can do if they are waiving the financing contingency is get a very, very thorough pre-approval and really get underwritten as much as possible prior to even making the offer. Some lenders will do this. You should talk to your buyer's agent to understand which lenders are better at doing this. For example, I know some lenders that will work with the buyer to verify the income, the employment, the assets, all of those things prior to even making an offer so that the pre-approval letter is very strong. Then the main risk left is on the property. My recommendation is that if this is something you're considering, you should really discuss it as part of the strategy with your buyer's agent. There's some clear benefits to doing it and becoming more competitive, but it's important to really understand the risks and the trade-offs of doing so. Thanks so much for watching. Send me your additional questions. Please subscribe to the channel. Thanks so much.